Okay, so we've got this awesome NVIDIA RTX A6000 GPU. Let's do some serious deep learning on this and have a look. Oh, wait, you guys want to see CyberPunk 2077? Okay, well, I did a whole video on that. The short answer is the frame rate with this high-end GPU and 4K output is above 70. Okay, so we've answered that. We've done Cyberpunk 2077. Now we can do some deep learning, right? Ethereum? What's Ethereum? Okay, it's mining. I mean, like Minecraft RTX? No, I know what Ethereum is. So let's go ahead. You've asked me about this a lot of times in the comments. Let's do Ethereum mining on an NVIDIA RTX A6000. And stick around to the end because at the end, we're going to also talk about pizza delivery with a Lamborghini. So, kind of the same concept. So, let's get started. Okay, so here we are. I am mining Ethereum using the RTX A6000. So let's just have a quick look. Now, I let this run for a bit. So I've mined about 0.0265 Ethereum, at least on my first run of this. When I was trying this out last week, I also mined 0.05 Ethereum. I think that's worth around $100. It's pretty much in free fall the last few days. So we'll see where that goes. If you put that into dollars, it's made about $43 in. I don't know. I've had this running maybe a couple of days testing this out while I was not using this card for anything else. The overall current hash rate that I'm getting, and this seems to be the key number that everybody is interested in, is 81.4 mh per second. And I've noticed even on the new NVIDIA CMP cards that are specifically built for this, that is the number that they're quoting. So there it is. That's the number, and you can see what this chart has been doing over some time. Now, let's talk about this briefly in terms of how I'm running this. I'm not going to do a how to mine Ethereum video. There's a million of those. Totally recommend Son of a Tech channel if you want to look at that. I followed his guide. It was quite useful. I modified it a little bit. So we are running lolminer, which is you can get that on GitHub, and I looked on their GitHub repository. It's binaries. So okay, we're gonna run binaries that we download from GitHub. What could possibly go wrong there for cryptocurrency? And when you install this too, your virus checker immediately flips out. So I ran this in a Docker image because I don't trust anybody on this kind of stuff. I don't trust binaries. So it's running in a Docker image that I created specifically for it. I'm not going to release that Docker image. I am not a crypto miner and I don't want to maintain it. And I'm sure somebody has a better Docker image out there that knows more about this than me. So it is basically connecting to this mining pool that I have a part of here. That is my wallet's hash. I'm pretty sure it's safe if you see that. I think it's like a public key. Nevertheless, I'm going to block that out. I don't see myself doing a lot of Ethereum mining, but $43, I'll at least transfer that to somewhere useful. And I mean this might so the A6000, as far as using it as a crypto, I mean this is a pretty decent hash rate in terms of a single GPU going at it from what I've read on this. So yeah, it's a pretty decent crypto miner, really. But then let's look at the estimate. It's estimating that USD monthly I'll make about $300 on this, minus my power cost, which I took a look at, and it's not that bad. It's maybe like $10, $15, $20 by my estimate, looking at what my local power rate is. Not something I plan on running long long-termish, so I mean, I might calculate that more. I'd ultimately compare my power bills probably if I was really going to do serious with this. So at $291 a month to basically buy my to pay this GPU back, we're looking at well over a year. So that's not going to happen. And that's part of the math, I think, that you do on these GPU cards in terms of how expensive is the GPU versus does it have enough to get you to what you're going to need to be profitable as a crypto miner. And that's why I made the comparison earlier. It's like you could buy a Lamborghini and use it to deliver pizza. They don't care what car you came to the house in to deliver the pizza. Now, maybe you could be an Uber driver, and because I've been picked up by some pretty expensive cars in Uber, and I think that makes some degree of sense because they can get a premium level, I forget what it's called, in Uber. You probably wouldn't want to have a Lamborghini as an Uber car because I don't think you're going to ever make that back. But if you're somebody who, I don't know, has a nice Lexus or Mercedes or something like that, and you want to earn some extra money on Uber, then yeah, perhaps it makes sense. And that's what I could see on this. Is if you're a deep learning person and like me, and you've got this GPU that sometimes maybe a week or so during the work week when I don't have a lot of time to work on projects, I could potentially have this thing mining and see what it's going to do. So it holds to the comparison, because would you want all those extra miles on your expensive sports car? Maybe. Do I want to potentially wear this card out? Ether mining, and generally I don't think there's too much of a risk there. The card is built to run hardcore on GANs and other things that I would train it on for potentially a week at a time. So I'm not too worried there. So who knows? I mean, that could be a potential for you if you're looking at buying an expensive card. Like what the hash rate on a 3090 would look like would be interesting. Okay, thank you for watching this video. If you are a crypto miner, probably subscribing to my channel won't do much for you. But if you're interested in deep learning, artificial intelligence, and other things like that, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and think about giving my channel a like. Thank you very much.